Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and today's Inktober video. We are on day 4. Today's urban legend is Herne the Hunter, or Herne. The way it's spelled, I like to call him Herne, but there's the whole silent letter thing, and that's a whole nother rant for a whole nother time. Before we get started on the story, I want to thank you guys so much for all the wonderful comments that we're getting. We're really enjoying chatting with you guys in the comment section of each video, and I'm very glad you guys are enjoying the stories. Also, I can't believe I forgot to ask this in the first video, but I want to know if you guys are doing Inktober. And if you are doing Inktober, please, please, please tag me on Instagram. I am having so much fun looking at all the great artists this month. There's so many cool concepts and so many cool interpretations of the prompt words. And even though I'm not following the prompts, I'm really enjoying seeing what you guys come up with. So please, please, please tag me on Instagram. I want to see what you guys are doing. Okay, now let's start the story of Herne the Hunter. In English folklore, Herne the Hunter is a ghost associated with Windsor Forest. Herne is said to naturally have antlers upon his head, ride a horse, torment cattle, and rattle chains. The earliest mention of Herne comes from William Shakespeare's 1597 play, The Merry Wives of Windsor. There have been several later attempts to connect Herne to historical figures, pagan deities, or ancient archetypes. Various theories have been proposed to the account of the origin of the character, none of which have been proved conclusive. And the source for many of the tales told of Herne remain unknown. Some see Herne as a spirit, sometimes a keeper in the Windsor Forest, who is seen to walk around about an oak with great ragged horns at midnight during wintertime. There are many different versions of this story. One was said that he was a huntsman employed by King Richard II. Men became jealous of his status and accused him of poaching on the king's land. Falsely charged with treason, Herne became an outcast among his former friends. Legend tells that in despair, he hung himself from an oak tree, which later became known as Herne's Oak. There is also another version of the story, according to which Herne was fatally wounded while saving King Richard from a charging stag. He was miraculously cured by a stranger, who tied the antlers of a dead stag to the dying man's brow. The stranger demanded payment in the form of Herne's skill. Crazed by the loss of that skill in the craft that he loved, Herne fled to the forest and hanged himself again from the oak tree. However, every night he rides once more, leading a spectral hunt, chasing the game of the Windsor Forest. On August 31st, 1863, the famous Windsor oak fell from natural causes, but was soon replaced by a new young oak tree by Queen Victoria on the same spot. Herne is depicted wearing the antlers of a great stag. He is considered a great hunter who possessed divine skills. Herne's antlers connect him to the deer, which was given a position of great honor. Legends tell that he carried a great horn and a wooden bow, riding a mighty black horse and accompanied by a pack of baying hounds. If someone crossed his path, they were swept up in it and often taken away, destined to ride with him for eternity. Encountering Herne the Hunter is a bad omen, especially to the royal family. According to local legend, Herne only appears in the Windsor Forest when needed, such as in some times of national crisis. I hope you guys enjoyed the urban legend of Herne the Hunter. Let's talk a little bit about the piece here. This one is not my favorite Inktober piece so far. I found that the trees were giving me a lot of trouble. They're birch trees, so they're white, and then the white ink that I used ended up having a bluish tint to it, so I had to end up covering that up with gouache. So this one was quite a process. I don't hate it, but it's not my favorite. But I do think that's one of the good things about Inktober. There's really no time to dwell on the things that you would have changed. because you have to move on to the next one. So I did learn a lot from this piece, which was awesome. And I'm definitely going to be doing some tree studies after Inktober is over. So all in all, another day down, another nice addition to the book. And I'll show you the finished piece here. Make sure you guys like this video if you liked it. And don't forget that the word of the day is pinned in the comment section below. And the collaboration playlist is right here on your screen. Don't forget to pop over to Courtney's channel and check out her video. And I will see you guys tomorrow.